For years now, the one thing I've wanted from modern platforms is for the original Crash Bandicoot games to be playable. Not just the PS1 games, but the post-Naughty Dog multi-platform games as well. Thankfully, there is a bit of hope, just a little bit, that some of these games might be playable on the PS5 or Xbox Series X. The new PlayStation Plus service allows you to play PS1 games, PS2, even PSP games, and PS3 if you want to stream them. But that doesn't matter in this case because there were no Crash PS3 games. Of course, they're going to be adding to that monthly, so you never know, the original Crash games might be playable there at some point in the future. Given how popular the original Crash games were on the PlayStation 1, it would be a good choice for them to bring them to that service. Not only that though, but it is the 25th anniversary of Crash Bandicoot this year. I can't remember what they said exactly at the beginning of the year, but they said they were going to continue to celebrate Crash's 25th anniversary and there's more to come. Nothing's come yet, so it's highly unlikely that this is exactly what they're gonna do, but they could release some sort of collection of older Crash games. There's no proof of that, it's just something that they could do and should do, to be honest. Activision, I know you like money, so just do it already. But as it stands, I would say the PlayStation 3 is the ultimate Crash Bandicoot machine. More specifically, the model that plays PS2 games, because they did discontinue that after a little bit. Any PS3, no matter what the model is, will allow you to play all of your PS1 discs. Even if you don't have the discs, you can still buy them on the PlayStation 3 store. Although I'm pretty sure that's closing down at some point soon. It was supposed to be last year, but then they extended it. So you might want to buy them now while you can. But you can buy those games on the PS Vita as well. But what the PS Vita can't do is play the PS2 Crash games. Again, if you have this model here, you can play any of your PS2 discs. So you'll be able to play Nitro Kart, Twinsanity, Tag Team Racing, Wrath of Cortex, Titans, Mind Over Mutant. Personally, I would still rather play the Xbox 360 versions of Crash of the Titans and Mind Over Mutant as opposed to the PS2 versions, but either way, the amount of Crash games you can play on this one system is amazing. It's got basically everything apart from the PS4 games, obviously. And I will say, PS2 games played on the PS3 look absolutely amazing. The thing is though, personally, and I think most people will agree with this, I'd much rather just have the games work on the PS5. Not everyone has these old consoles, not everyone has space to set up multiple consoles, which is why I'm really happy with what Sony, Microsoft, and Nintendo are doing right now. They're making their older games playable on their newer systems so that you don't need all these things set up. One day, and it might take a couple years, but there'll be a big library of older PlayStation games playable on the PS5. That might include the Crash games. Nintendo are currently adding Nintendo 64 games to the Switch. Hopefully, at the rate that they're going, we might even have Game Boy Advance games by 2050, possibly even GameCube. But they're still doing it, and I appreciate it nonetheless. I don't need my N64 setup anymore at this point, basically. And the Series X has tons of backwards compatible games, it's got Game Pass. I don't think there'll ever be any ultimate system that just has everything playable in a good way. I think there'll always be certain games that you have to go back and play on older consoles if you don't want to emulate them. But we can get close to an ultimate system that plays a wide variety of older games. It's the reason I've still got my Wii U set up, not really for Wii U games, but with the added benefit of it playing all my Wii games on top of a bunch of virtual console games. But as far as the Crash Bandicoot series goes, the PS3 is winning right now. That being said, thank you for watching, I hope you all enjoyed, definitely subscribe if you're new here, and let me know down below if you still have one of these bad boys. I would say they are very much worth it, definitely pick one up if you can. That being said, thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in my next video. Oh, and there's one more thing that I forgot to mention. Another big reason as to why I'd rather play all my older games on a PS5 as opposed to a PS3 is this. Is this too much to handle, PS3?